Hello everybody, in this lecture we will be discussing about stability factor for fixed bias common emitter circuit. So this is the basic fixed biasing circuit. Now we will be calculating the value of S, stability factor denoted by S, from this circuit. In this circuit the quiescent base and collector currents are provided by a single battery of voltage VCC, you can see. And this will bias the emitter junction in the forward direction and collector junction in the reverse direction. The voltage VBE is small as compared to VCC, so that will be ignored in the calculations. And we can calculate the quiescent base current approximately by, we can write IB equal to approximately VCC minus VBE divided by RB. So if we ignore VBE, then we may write IB equal to approximately equal to, this is equal to, and IB approximately equal to VCC by RB. So RB is the resistance shown over here, and you can see here that IB is independent of the collector current IC. And since IB will be of constant value, so that is why it is called fixed bias, because it is dependent only on VCC and RB, both of which are constants. Now if the Q point is selected in the active region of the output characteristics of this circuit, then alpha is a constant. Alpha is the gain, you know, independent of collector voltage. So the collector current expressed in this form, the collector current IC can be expressed as alpha by, in terms of alpha, alpha by 1 minus alpha IB plus 1 by 1 minus alpha ICO. This is one of the important current expressions we have discussed during the discussion about BJT, basic transistor amplifier. So in terms of alpha and ICO, this is the expression for IC, collector current. And if we now differentiate this equation with respect to ICO, we can get S, because S is, you know, S is having the formula DIC by DICO. So if we now differentiate this equation with respect to ICO, we can get 1 by 1 minus alpha, if we differentiate this with respect to ICO, because this will be a constant value, because IB will be a constant value and alpha is also a constant. So it is just DIC by DICO, and here 1 by 1 minus alpha is constant. So this is the expression of stability factor for fixed bias circuit. Now if we assume alpha as 0.98 typically, then from here we may get S equal to 50. So please remember this expression, 1 by 1 minus alpha is the formula for calculating stability factor for fixed bias circuit. So S equal to 50 means IC increases 50 times faster than ICO, and thus we can say this circuit does not provide a stable operating point. Instead, it provides immense scope for the transistor to be destroyed by thermal runaway, because with respect to ICO, IC will be increasing 50 times higher, because AC is having a huge value, and that is very bad, not very healthy for a transistor. So the transistor may be destroyed by thermal runaway. And also there is another drawback of this circuit, that when a transistor is replaced by another of the same type, the quiescent currents and voltages may differ appreciably. So there will be a shift of the quiescent operating point because of that. Let us now discuss about the collector to base bias circuit and its calculation of stability factor S. So this is the basic collector to base bias circuit, and our intention is to calculate the stability factor for this circuit. So you are familiar with this circuit. When the resistance RB connected between base and collector of the transistor, rather than between the base and positive terminal of the battery. So there is a basic difference between these two circuits, you know. I am not extending my discussion about that, because the position of RB, the connection of RB is changed here. and you are already familiar about this change, because I have discussed with you about the configuration of these circuits in one previous lecture. So in this lecture, what we will see that we will calculate the stability factor from this circuit. So this modified circuit from the fixed bus is capable of giving better stability factor. So let us see how that can happen. The rise in IC, that is the collector current, due to increase in temperature of the transistor or due to the replacement of the transistor, that means by any means, if IC increases, it will mean that this increase of IC will increase the voltage drop across the resistance RC, because IC will be flowing through this RC and IC is far more greater than IB. So primarily the drop across RC is due to IC, due to the increase of IC, and this is accompanied by a decrease in VC. So if this IC is increased, that means this drop, because this VC is nothing but VCC minus this drop. So this VC will be decreased if this drop is increased across RC. So we can say that because VCC is constant, so the decrease in VCE results in a decrease in the base current IB. Now if VC, so this decrease in VCE will result in a decrease in base current, because VC will directly having an impact of base current, because VC is VC minus V, and VC is responsible for the generation of base current. So base current will be decreased, and if base current is decreased, that will make up the increase of the IC, because base current is related with IC collector current via beta. Since beta is constant, so if base current is decreased, that means it will try to make IC decrease also. So initially, since IC had increased, and because of that everything has been followed, so we can say that eventually the IC will be controlled and IC will be decreased. So in other words, the circuit will try to compensate for the increase of IC by decreasing IB arising from the temperature changes or from transistor replacements. That means for adjusting for different transistor types. Now if we apply Kirchhoff's voltage law in this circuit to represent VCE, we can write IBRB for input loop. This is for input loop, that is this side, the input loop or input circuit. VC is IBRB plus VB. So this VC will be IBRB plus VB. VB is nothing but this much. So this is VB. This side is plus and this side is minus. So this VB plus IBRB, IB, and this is RB. So in this loop, this is the equation using KVL. And from the output loop, we can write VCC equal to IC plus IB into RC from here. So this is the drop across this RC due to IC plus IB plus VC. So we are having two equations, one from the input loop, another from the output loop or circuit. Now substituting the value of VCE from the first equation into the second equation, we can write, substitute this VC over here. So what we can write? VCC equal to IC plus IB into RC plus IBRB plus VB. Now since VB is very small, so we can ignore it. So we can write VCC as approximately equal to IC plus IB into RC plus IBRB. Now from here calculate IB. It should be VCC minus ICRL ICRC, not RL, RC, VCC minus ICRC divided by RC plus RB. So give this equation as number 3. Now combining this equation with the equation I have mentioned in the previous case, that is the basic one of the basic fundamental transistor current equation, that is IC equal to alpha by 1 minus alpha IB plus 1 by 1 minus alpha ICO. Now if we combine these two equations, then we may write IC. Now put IB from here into this equation, then IC should be alpha by 1 minus alpha whole into VCC minus ICRC divided by RC plus RB plus 1 by 1 minus alpha into ICO. So from here we can just rearrange this equation, or we can write IC into taking IC as common from here, breaking this term and taking to the left hand side, and along with also taking IC as common, 1 minus alpha plus alpha RC divided by RC plus RB, that is equal to ICO plus alpha VCC by RC plus RB. So this step can be written after this step. Now the stability factor can be calculated by differentiating IC with respect to ICO. So now we know that S equal to DIC by DICO. So just differentiate this equation. So what we get from here? The result should be 1 by 1 minus alpha plus alpha RC divided by RC plus RB. So if we now replace with beta from the relation between alpha and beta, we may get beta plus 1 by 1 minus beta RC divided by RC plus RB. So just remember this equation in terms of either alpha or beta for calculation of stability factor for collector bias circuit. And this beta relation is obtained from this relation, beta equal to alpha by 1 minus alpha. From this relation, the relation between alpha and beta, we have just substituted in this, and we are getting stability factor in terms of beta. So we can say that the stability factor here is dependent on the value of beta and also RC and RB. So the right hand side of this equation, S equal to this equation, is smaller than the corresponding right hand side of this equation, the previous one, 1 by 1 minus alpha, because here it is 1 by 1 minus alpha plus there is a term in the denominator. So obviously you can, if you compare the stability factor of these two equations, these two biasing circuits, one is this one, 1 by 1 minus alpha, and for this one, the previous one and this one, so this one is having an extra term at the denominator. That means for collector to base bias circuit, the stability factor will be reduced further than the fixed bias circuit. So we can say that there is an improvement in stability in case of collector to base bias circuit than in case of fixed bias circuit. Also, when RC is far far less than RB, the improvement is not very much but only marginal. That is, RC is far far less than RB. That means if RC is far far less than RB, that means we can get the improvement in very marginal sense. That means RC less than RB means this term will be a very small term, and then we can neglect this term with respect to 1 minus alpha. So if we neglect this term with respect to 1 minus alpha, so S will become 1 by 1 minus alpha, and that is equal to the fixed bias circuit. That means for RC to be very less than RB, the stability factor of collector to base bias circuit will almost become equal to the stability factor of fixed bias circuit. So in that case, we can say that the improvement is not very much high or not very better than the previous case. So only we can establish that improvement can be done in the stability factor if we consider this formula for improvement of stability factor, where the denominator term is further reduced than the previous expression. Now let us see the third part, that is using voltage divider bias circuit calculation of stability factor. So this is the third one. So this is the basic voltage divider bias circuit. It is the most commonly used bias circuit, you know, for getting stable operating point. The resistances R1, R2, RE and RC and supply voltage VCC will provide proper forward bias to the emitter base junction and reverse bias to the collector base junction. This circuit will offer improvement in the operating point, and stability will be clear from the discussion I will be having right now. The collector current IC develops a voltage drop across the resistance RE, this one, because the collector current will flow in this direction. So this IC that is being flown over here, this IC, the collector current, develops a voltage drop across the resistance RE. This it will flow across this resistance because IC is approximately equal to IE. So whatever is current that is flowing as IC will be approximately equal to IE, and that will be flown through the emitter resistor. Now when the collector current increases due to rise in temperature, that means why we are again and again discussing the increase of collector current, because we are calculating S means it is DICO, that means with respect to ICO how much change is happening in the collector current. So for each and every explanation of the circuit operation of these bias circuits, always we need to have a closer look on the change in the collector current IC. So here also, if collector current IC increases due to rise in temperature or other reasons, the voltage drop across RE, that means this emitter resistance, will be increased, making the base terminal, if voltage drop is increased in this area, that means it will increase the voltage at this node, which is the VE, that is the emitter node. Now if emitter node voltage is increased, that means the base terminal will become less positive with respect to the emitter terminal, because base terminal is this one and emitter terminal is this one. Generally we specify VBE as VB minus VE. So we generally specify base terminal to be at more positive potential than emitter terminal. Now if emitter terminal voltage is increased, that means base terminal positivity will be lesser than the emitter terminal. Okay, so this will lower the base current. That means we can say that VBE will be getting down for that. Now if VBE is getting down, that means the base emitter junction forward biasing is getting down. That means the input base current, that is which is IB, it will be getting down. And it will, if IB is getting down, that means it will in turn make the collector current getting down. So IB will immediately try to decrease the collector current IC. That means it will try to compensate for the increase of the collector current, for which all these changes are happening. So thereby it can make stable the Q point. Now you have seen in my earlier discussion about voltage divider biasing technique, we have applied the Thevenin's theorem to find a simplified version of this circuit. And if we now apply to this, if we now apply Thevenin's theorem to this circuit, where the input loop of the circuit. That means to this area of the circuit, if we apply the Thevenin's theorem, we get the Thevenin's voltage and Thevenin's resistance. Now, Thevenin's voltage is denoted by Vt, you have seen in earlier lectures, and Thevenin's resistance denoted by Rt. So, this Vt is given by, as per this circuit, Vcc into, you know, it is R2 by R1 plus R2, using this potential divider circuit. So, this is the Thevenin's voltage expression. Now, what is Rt? Rt is R1 parallel with R2. So, these are the results. So, now, applying Kirchhoff's voltage law to the input circuit or the input loop, that means to this side, we can write IB RT plus VBE plus IB plus IC into RE, that is equal to VT. Now, before explaining this, we need to first draw the equivalent circuit, that is the Thevenin's equivalent circuit. After applying this Thevenin's theorem to this circuit, the simplified form of the circuit will be look like this. This is VCC and this is IC, this is RC, and here it is VCE, this is RE, and this is IC plus IB. And here it is IB, the base current, and this is the Thevenin's resistance RT, and this is the Thevenin's voltage VT. So this is the simplified form of this circuit after applying the Thevenin's theorem. Now, at the input circuit here, you can see IB RT, the drop across RT, plus VB, it is the base emitter junction voltage, plus IB plus IC into RE. And IB plus IC is flowing through this resistance RE. So, within this loop, applying KVL, this is equal to the voltage source VT. So, this is as per the input circuit or input loop. So, this is equation number one for here, this one. Now, if we neglect VB, VB is ignored. So, that means and also if we solve IB from this equation, ignoring VB, then we can write this as VT minus ICRE divided by RT plus RE. Okay, so this is equation number 2 for here. We have found IB from here. Now, if we substitute again, once again, the one of the useful current expression, that is IC equal to alpha by 1 minus alpha IB plus 1 by 1 minus alpha ICO. If we substitute IB from here into this equation, we can get IC equal to alpha by 1 minus alpha into VT minus ICRE by RT plus RE plus 1 by 1 minus alpha ICO. Now, if we rearrange this equation, we may write from here 1 minus alpha into IC, that is equal to ICO plus alpha into VT minus ICRE divided by RT plus RE. So, this is the equation number, suppose this is equation number 3. Now the stability factor can be calculated by differentiating this equation with respect to ICO, DIC by DICO, and simplifying we get 1 by 1 minus alpha plus alpha into RE by RE plus RT. And that is equal to beta plus 1 by 1 plus beta RE divided by RE plus RT. If we substitute alpha equal to beta by 1 plus beta, here we can get this one. So this is the expression for stability factor for voltage divider circuit. Now here you can see that as RT tends to 0, if we consider RT to be going towards 0 here, then we can cancel RE and RE. If RT tends to 0, we can cancel RE and RE, alpha and plus alpha minus alpha. So S in that case will become tends to 1. And for finite values of RT, S is greater than unity. So this means S is greater than 1 for finite RT. So this means that IC always increases faster than ICO. That means S is a positive quantity, increases IC increases faster than ICO. By keeping the Q point fixed, if RT is reduced, by reducing R1 and R2, then the current drawn by R1 and R2 increases, causing more power loss. Now if we reduce R1 and R2 for reducing RT towards 0, that means more and more current will be drawn through this region, and there will be a more power loss through these resistances R1 and R2. On the other hand, when RT is held fixed but RE is increased, if we increase RE keeping RT fixed, that means R1 R2 fixed, in that case to lower the S, because if RE is if RE is increased, that means the denominator will be increased, that means stability factor will be decreased. So the variation of IC can be managed, can be controlled, can be decreased. So either we can make RT tends to 0, or we can make RE to increase. So now if we make RE to increase, that means to lower the stability factor value S, the supply voltage VCC must also be increased to make the Q point unchanged, because if RE is increased, then the current flow through this RE will become less. So to get back to the same current flow, VCC needs to be accordingly increased, so that the Q point or the biasing condition for this circuit will remain unchanged. So this will also cause more power loss, because if VCC is increased, the power loss in the other resistances will also increase. So these methods for improving the stability are therefore not very efficient. Now when the above circuit, this biasing technique is used for amplification of AC signals, there will be an AC voltage drop across the emitter resistance RE, and this will produce a negative feedback and reduction in gain, because negative feedback will you will see later in the discussion during the discussion on feedback amplifier, that negative feedback will decrease the gain of the circuit. So to overcome this effect, a capacitor having negligible reactance at the lowest frequency of the input signal is connected across RE here, and which is called the bypass capacitor. I have already discussed about it with you in the last lecture, and it will short circuit the AC signal to go through this RE. So there will not be any AC signal component going through this RE, and so we can say that the effect of negative feedback due to the connection of RE and CE in parallel will be reduced, and the reduction of gain will be not that much more in for this type of biasing technique. So there will be an appreciable amplification of AC signals could be possible via due to the application, due to the use of this circuit. Here in this lecture, we have seen how to derive the stability factor formulas for three different types of biasing techniques, and you need to remember the formula for each and every biasing stability factor formula for each and every biasing technique.